We are going to learn about the infrared spectroscopy and its IR bands, the various IR bands that we see in an IR spectrum. Okay, let's start with our journey now. The IR spectroscopy actually provides a fast and effective way to identify the functional groups that are present in a molecule just by looking to the absorption bands that correspond to the bond types which are present in those functional group present in the molecule actually. It is, however, important to remember that the absorption frequency of a given bond type can vary somewhat depending upon the structure. So let's try to take out some of the important points from the IR spectrum and learn the bands easily. We start with the significant IR band regions. In the figure, you can see that the IR spectrum ranges from 2500 to 4000 centimeter inverse. Now, in this region of the spectrum, we can see a broad band which is present here. Actually, this is the region which is assigned to the presence of OH stretching. The presence of CH stretching is also found in this region, and the NH stretching band is also observed in this region. So, in other words, whenever a compound contains an OH group, you just have to look at the presence of the band in this region from 2500 to 4000 centimeter inverse. Or if a CH group is present in the molecule, then definitely the CH stretching band will be observed in this region only, and it is the CH stretching band over here in the region of 3300 to 2700 centimeter inverse, which is actually a medium band. Remember, the strong, medium and the weak bands are in reference to the amount of the change in dipole moment. From the figure, you can see that the table also corresponds that the NH and the OH band, they lie in the same range from 2500 to 4000 centimeter inverse, although their individual frequency values are differing from each other quite a little bit. But the major difference that we observe just on having a first look at the band is that the OH band is a strong broad band, right? Whereas the NH band, which is observed in this region of IR spectrum, is actually a medium broad band. So whenever we get a very strong band, okay, very deep dip in the band, that means it is referring to the OH, the presence of the OH group in the molecule, right? Okay, the second part of the IR spectrum actually that we are going to study now lies from the 1600 to 1800 centimeter inverse. As you can see in this spectrum, this is the band that we are talking about, from 1600 to 1800 centimeter inverse. This region is actually the region that belongs to the double bond which is present in the molecule. Whenever a double bond is present in the molecule, maybe due to the presence of like between two carbon atoms, or between carbon and oxygen, or it can be carbon and nitrogen, whatever double bond is present in the molecule, it is definitely going to give rise to a band in the IR spectrum. And that band, how do we locate it? We will just have a look, a search in the region from 1600 to 1800 centimeter inverse. Okay, so we label it as a double bond region, and this is what we can summarize: the carbon oxygen double bond, that is the carbonyl group. Here I would like to mention over here one thing, that this is one of the most significant groups which is present in the molecules. And why? Because this carbonyl group is present in aldehydes, ketones, as well as in carboxylic acids also, right? So this carbonyl group, which carries a double bond between carbon and oxygen, lies in the wave number range of 1780 to 1650 centimeter inverse, and this is a very strong band which we observe, like this, like the one shown in the figure. It's a strong band. It's one of the strong bands, right? So carbonyl group is seen as a one of the strong bands in the spectrum. Okay, after this we come to the next region of our IR spectrum, that lies from 2000 to 2500 centimeter inverse. In this spectrum that we have shown, there is no significant band in this region, right? Why? Because the molecule may not be having the presence of the group, functional group that lies in this region. Okay, so if the functional group is not present, definitely there will be no band seen in the IR spectrum in that region. And what to does this region belongs to? Let's see. It is the region of triple bond. Okay, so if carbon-carbon triple bond is present, or a triple bond between carbon and nitrogen, that is the nitrile group, is present in the molecule, then we are definitely going to have a band between 2000 to 2500 centimeter inverse. Okay, so we have studied three regions of the IR spectrum. First was belonging to the stretching bands due to OH group, due to CH, or third was due to NH group. Right, that second category, or the second region of the IR spectrum that we studied, was belonging to the double bond region, and this is the third region that we have just mentioned, from 2000 to 2500 centimeter inverse, and this is the region of triple bond. Okay, so you can learn these regions of spectrum that will make your life easy with the bands that you are getting in the question. So the learning outcomes so far are, it is only alkenes and aromatics that show CH stretching slightly at a position above 3000 centimeter inverse. That means the compounds that contain the double bond we are talking about. So we get a band slightly at a higher position from 3000 centimeter inverse, whereas if the compound does not contain a double bond, then what is the case? Then the CH stretch may be seen below 3000 centimeter inverse, or definitely it is seen below 3000 centimeter inverse. This is how we can differentiate between the CH stretching band of an alkene or an alkane, or rather an aromatic compound. Okay, so now I think you can differentiate between the CH stretching bands of any of these three types of molecules. And moreover, there are many changes which are observed in the spectrum when one or more functional group, or let's say a hetero atom like nitrogen or oxygen, get added to the molecule. And this basically makes the spectrum a little bit of complex. Okay, that we'll see later on. We now come to the next topic, that is overtones, right? Overtones is not a complicated terminology, as some students get confused over here. You just try to make it simplified. These are the additional bands. Okay, you remember the overtones in the music, right? So similarly, these are the additional bands which occur as overtones. Okay, for example, we have taken ethyl acetate over here. Right, in this spectrum of ethyl acetate, you can see the normal carbonyl stretch, that is the normal C double bond O stretch, which is approximately at 1740 centimeter inverse in the spectrum. So this is the normal stretch of the carbonyl group, the ester group present in the ethyl acetate. Now this stretching band can be correlated with a tiny weak peak over here at around 3478 centimeter inverse, which is actually the overtone of the carbonyl stretch present at 1740. Now make it out whether this is an overtone or not, you just take this thumb rule that overtones may occur approximately at, let's say, 1 by 2 or 1 by 3 or 1 by 4 values, and so on and so forth, of the wavelength of the fundamental mode, right? Fundamental mode wherein the original first transition was taking place, right? So if it was at 1740 over here, the band is at 1740 due to carbonyl group, or let's say the carbon double bond oxygen group, right? So what will be the double value of 1740? Approximately it is 3400 centimeter inverse, right? So at around 3400 centimeter inverse, we are going to have a band which is a weak band actually, and is what? It is the overtone of this carbon oxygen double bond. In this spectrum, this band occurs at 3478 centimeter inverse. So this is the overtone of carbon oxygen stretching band, okay, that occurs at almost this twice value of the wave number as of the fundamental band. Overturns actually may arise in two ways. If a molecule is in the lowest or the first vibrational state and it gets excited to the third vibrational level instead of second level. So the energy required is almost the twice as which was required for the excitation to the second vibrational state, definitely one stage above it, okay. And it is not actually twice as much because the higher levels tend to lie closer together than the lower levels, that we can ignore right now for this lecture is concerned. So unfortunately, what has been observed, however, that the intensities of the overtones are just 1/10 or it can be up to 1/100 of the fundamental band. That you can see from here also, the intensity of this overtone band is far less than the fundamental band, which is this one, right? So fundamental band is this, and intensity, it lies from 1/10 to 1/100 of that of the fundamental band. The intensity of the overtone decreases as the order of the overtone increases. That is, the second overtone is less intense than the first overtone, right? And thereon it goes. As a result, the second and the higher overtones, they are rare, while the first overtones are observed only for the strong bands. So this is overtone, means another band which is at just almost half, it makes it twice of the value of the fundamental band. Okay, or in other words, the fundamental band is approximately at half of its value. Okay, and how, second thing, how to diagnose it? First point is just see the wave number. It should be just twice as the wave number of the fundamental band. And the second point to demarcate it from the other bands is that its intensity will be very less, from 1/10 to 1/100 of the value of the fundamental bands which are present in the molecule. Okay, which are present in the molecule. So this is about the overtones. And so far, what are the learning points, the learning outcomes we have attained is the overtones appear at approximately 1/2 or 1/3 or 1/4 and so on and so forth on the wavelength of the fundamental mode that we are talking about. And the second thing is that these overtones may arise if a molecule is in the lowest or the first vibrational state and it gets excited to the third vibrational level instead of second one. Okay, and the intensity of the overtone actually decreases as the order of the overtone increases. Okay, so more the order, more less intense will be the band. Okay, I hope this is clear. So let's move on to the next small topic, that is Fermi resonance, basically of equal importance. Fermi resonance is also understood with the term called as coupled interaction. Okay, now as the term suggests, coupled means two things are there at one time. Like for example, in propionic anhydride spectrum, IR spectrum, we see a pair of the bands present over here. Okay, now this pair actually lies in the range of 1700 to 1800. So definitely it belongs to the carbonyl group that we have just studied. Okay, so there is a pair which belongs to the carbonyl group. Now, how do we call it as Fermi resonance? First of all, we can see the three CH stretching bands over here, 1, 2 and 3. These three CH stretching bands, so the groups in the spectrum of propionic anhydride is seen. Okay, now the vibrational coupling actually occurs between two bonds. Remember, coupling occurs whenever two bonds are present and they are vibrating individually near the same frequency. So nearly at the same frequency the two bonds are vibrating, and they are nearer to each other also in the structure also. Yes, structure as well. And provided that the bonds are reasonably close in the molecule. So in that case, what happens, the coupling vibrations may both be fundamental or A fundamental vibration may couple with the overtone. So it can be any case. A coupling fundamental can couple with the overtone also that we have just studied, or it can be with one another. So here it is taking place. Okay, we see a pair over here of this carbonyl. Now what is happening here? Carbonyl group 1 is here and carbonyl group 2 is also here. Fine. So in the structure of the molecule, the two carbonyl groups are very near to one another. So they are vibrating with the almost the same frequencies, and they are joined by only single atom in between. In that case, when the band is obtained, it actually splits like this, or it couples like this, as we can see in the spectrum also. So this is called as Fermi resonance. Fermi, actually it is given on the name of the person who first described it. It was Enrico Fermi. Okay, now strong vibrational coupling between stretching vibrations, it actually requires a common atom between the groups, like the oxygen atom present over here. Okay, so these two show carbonyl stretching absorptions with the separation of only 60 centimeter inverse between them. So there will be a very small difference of wave number in between these bands. This is how we say, okay, these two are occurring together. And why? Because the carbonyl groups are nearer to each other. That is the case of Fermi resonance. So the coupling vibrations may both be fundamental, or a fundamental vibration may couple with the overtone. This is Fermi resonance. Okay. So there are three types of bands that we have studied. Fundamental bands, that is excitation from the ground to the lowest energy or to the excited state, and the overtone bands, excitation from the ground to the next higher energy state, and Fermi resonance, wherein coupling of the vibrational bands is taking place. Right. So coming up with our next videos, we shall discuss about the different factors that affect the IR spectrum. Till then. Thank you.